One, two, get down. Bandit called to be the boss. Bandit called to be the boss.
Hi, it's Paul from Comedy Works, and we're in Bradwell in Braintree. Got a 1972 Beetle. My dad was into cars, and I quite grew up around them. He used to fix his own cars, and yeah, he actually had an early buy, my dad, 1970. And as a kid, I remember going away in that, and he used to take me to football in it. But yeah, we used to take me up to the cruise night at Lakeside back in the late 80s. Go to a show, chat to whoever you like, doesn't matter who you are, what you do, the people are great. We've just secured a fantastic new venue in Colchester, an American diner, totally brand new, huge car park with great entrance for low and slow cars, things like that. I definitely have a passion for the retro stuff. Definitely born in the wrong era, I think this is the way I put it.
Called to be the boss. Paid the call to be the boss. I paid the call to be the boss. Look at me, you know what to see.
Hi, my name is Nick Gatt, and it's a 1968 original painted logo bus. The bus sat in a barn in Tennessee for quite a few years. It was parked in the blocking a hole up in the front of the barn. Then obviously a tornado came along, destroyed the barn, but the bus survived. It's got the original logos on from the Yacht Broker company. Lowered it and a new set of South African Rostar wheels. Pretty much, yeah, it's all original. Runs like a dream. First car was a VW camper, which my old man gave to me. Having it after about 6 months, lowered it, gave him the ump. The headlining was full of cat biscuits for some reason, so yeah, it was quite a nice little find. But I've got a dog, so but she don't like cat biscuits. Well, I've got obviously a telephone bought the other day for £3, so the old Bill love it when you see it driving down the road and you can't really say you've got a mobile, so it's nice just to get away. It's better than watching telly at home, and while the weather's like this, it's nothing better than going camping away for a weekend.
Mark Flynn, it's a 1967 Euro spec Dutch import Beetle.
When I bought it, it was in a little bit of a state. It had been sitting in the field for many, many years, so underneath it was completely rotten. On top it is pretty much as you see it now, but it was missing a couple of little bits. It had a rear end that had been chopped off at some point as well. I do have quite a few little random odds and ends dotted around in here, I suppose. Some of my favourites include a particular specialist magazine for gentlemen, let's say from the 60s. It's correct for the year and it matches, it's 1967. But there are bits in here that have stayed with me in every vehicle, carried through, bits that have been taken off my first ever Beetle, and bits from the last God knows how many years I've been into cars, really. I got into the Volkswagen scene pretty much just after buying my first one. It's something about when you start to drive Beetles and you never really see before unless you're in the scene. You start to get waved at by other people that you think you don't know. You definitely make some good friends and comrades from being amongst the Volkswagen scene, particularly the kinds of people that you meet. There's another good friend of ours, Steve Payne, a guy called Alan. Particularly people we've met at, say, the Volkswagen meets on the A12. In terms of my car, it's difficult to say what kind of look that I would say it fits in with. It's a little bit ratty, it's a little bit sort of retro car in many ways. I like to think of it as just original and just it's just me really, it's just a bit more character.